Hi, this is Carl the Landscape Guy. Today I want to build a large floating net basket which is going to be used in a natural pond. Therein, larger fish can temporarily be held in quarantine or it can be used for raising young fish. There are different floating nets available, but they're pretty expensive and they don't really fit my needs exactly. I will now show the construction step by step and I'll explain what I do. At the end, I'll test the new floating net basket in a natural pond. First, I'm planning out exactly how big the keeping net is going to be, and I'm making a drawing of it. It is going to be 2.2 meters long, 1.2 meters wide, and 0.8 meters deep. This drawing shows the net spread out. It is going to be made out of one piece, that way I save some seams. I decided to use weatherproof fishnet mesh type PES300, which has 3 millimeters mesh width, and I ordered 10 square meters at netzealaat.de. It is easier to cut the mesh on level ground using the straight joints from the terrace, for example. That way I can easily get these angles rectangular. With tape measure, ruler, and marker pen, the cuts are now transferred from the paper drawing onto the mesh. Since the mesh is to be cut the same way on both ends, I'm folding it once in order to be able to cut both ends simultaneously. Slipping can be prevented by fixation with needles. Then the cuts are easily carried out with sharp scissors. Now the net is sewn together according to the drawing to a cuboid. Polyester sewing thread is used. Sewing works well if it's a stiff mesh like this one. The net is now folded around like this and stitched again. That way it's more durable and it looks nicer too. It is sewn with tiny stitches because they consume more thread length and therefore the seams are stretchy. The net remains resilient and the thread doesn't rip. The fish keeping net will float on the water through pipes later. Therefore, the net is flipped on the edges and sewn as a white seam. So the float tube can later be simply inserted into the so-formed tunnel. This tunnel is left open at one spot so that the pipe can be inserted later. As floating tubes, I use PVC pipes 7.5 centimeters in diameter. These are stable, have an inconspicuous color, rubble seals on the connections, and I can take it apart at any time again. I use 2 meter pieces for the long sides and 1 meter pieces for the short sides. Each corner is built with two 45 degree pipe elbows. You can get all these pipes at a hardware store. All seals are treated with lubricant. That way, they can be pushed in easier and seal off better. The floating tube ring is left open at one point so that I can slide on the sewn net. It works best to have someone helping to hold the pipes while you slide it on. Now it looks quite like a fish keeping net already. But I want to add a removable cover net. This should keep the fish safe from predators like herons and cormorants, and keep the fish from jumping out. For this, I use some PVC pipes again. This time I use 87 degree pipe elbows for the corners. The pipes need to be shortened a little this time, as the lid is going to sit inside the floating pipes of the net. I'm cutting off about 7 centimeters and deburr the edges. For a nice mark around, you can use a piece of pipe, just like this. Now all pieces are put together. A net will now be stretched onto this pipe frame. To secure the net, screws are placed into the pipes. These screws can be set at the crossing points, which gives additional stability. In between, more screws are set centrally. Now the net can easily be put on. It is a stable bird netting that is stretched with a threaded string around. I'm going to want to put some weight on the inside of the floating net basket to keep it hanging down underwater. Therefore, I got some thin cable pipes and elbows. I stuffed some metal wire into the small pipes to make them heavy, and I cut them to the right length. Now I'm gluing the pipes and the elbows together to form a frame that fits in the inside of the net basket. I drill small holes into the pipes for the air to come out underwater. Allow the glue to dry and done. Now my new fish keeping net basket can be set into the water. It now consists of 3 parts: the net with float tubes, the cover, and the weighting. I put the net in first. Then I put in the weighting. The tube fills up with water and sinks to the bottom, so the net doesn't wrinkle and hangs down nicely underwater, so the fish always have enough room to swim. Now the cover net is put on. The screws are mounted the way that they cannot damage the white netting outside. If you now want to put a fish in, just slide the cover off a little bit. If you want to take out some fish, you can just take out the whole net out of the water. There's a nice gap between the covering net and the water surface, which makes feeding through the net possible without problems. Of course, you can also use a smaller mesh cover net. The relatively large sized tubes keep everything safely floating on the surface. Overall, I think my new floating net basket is very convenient. The young fish have plenty of space for swimming, they're protected from birds, and I can feed and watch them while they swim on their usual water. Overall, I spent about $90 for the materials. I hope that this video was helpful, and I wish you good luck for your projects. Helpful comments are always appreciated. Take a look at my channel if you like, there are many pond and landscaping videos. Please don't forget to subscribe. I see you next time. I'm Carl, the Landscape Guy.